Hello everyone. So this is lecture 2, class 9, subject English. Topic of this lecture is determiners. In the previous lecture, we discussed about that what are determiners. So what are determiners? A determiner is a word which limits or fixes the meaning of a noun. Then we discussed about the types of determiners. How many types of determiners were there? There were 5 types of determiners: article determiners, possessive determiners, demonstrative determiners, quantitative determiners, and numeral determiners. Then we also discussed about the uses of article determiners. There were 2 types of article determiners: definite and indefinite. What was the definite article? The. And indefinite? A and an. Then indefinite articles are given as name indefinite as they do not refer to a particular thing, right? They are also used, their uses were discussed. Then definite article, that is the, has been given this name definite, as the is always used with a particular thing, with a definite thing. And the various uses of a, an, and the were discussed. So this was about the previous lecture. Now moving on to the next type of possessive determiners. Now what are possessive determiners? They are actually possessive adjectives only. Possessive, this word implies ownership. Words like my, our, your, his, her, it, there are known as possessive determiners. They come before nouns and indicate ownership of noun. Now when they are coming before noun, that means they are qualifying noun, and so they are also given the name possessive adjectives. Their name like my leg hurts, bring your books with you. So such words are emphasizing the ownership of that particular noun. That means possessive determiners are the determiners that shows the ownership, that indicates the ownership of a noun in the sentence. So this was about possessive determiners. Now next type we have is demonstrative determiners. Now demonstrative determiners, you are familiar with this word also. Demonstrative, which points out the things, places, or persons. They are also another name, like possessive determiners are known as possessive adjectives. Similarly, demonstrative determiners are also known as demonstrative adjectives. This, that, these, those. Now, this and that are used with singular. These and those are used with plural. This and that refers to the nearby objects or persons. These and those refers to the objects or the person far away from the speaker. Like, now through this table it will be very much clear with you that this is and that, they are used with singular, and this is used for nearby objects, that is used for far away objects. Similarly, these, plural, used for plural things, objects and persons, and is used for nearby objects. Those, plural, used with plural things, objects and persons, and for far away things, when the things or the objects which are far away from the speaker. So this was about possessive determiners and demonstrative determiners. Now another type is numeral determiners, which are further classified into 3 types: definite, indefinite, and distributive. Now, definite are further segregated in 2 parts, cardinal and ordinal. As the word definite suggests, definite means what? Exact, definite number. So, numeral determiners are the determiners which refers to the number. Definite numeral means which refers to the definite or the exact number. Now cardinal, 5, 8, 4, 10, that means cardinals, which are used before countable nouns. Ordinal, which are used to indicate the order. Fourth, the fourth boy sitting in this row is my friend. Similarly, so they are segregated in two parts, cardinal and ordinal. Both are suggesting the definite or the exact number of things, objects or persons. Now, we will switch to indefinite and distributive determiners with their individual uses. Right? Now see, another type of determiners is quantitative determiners. So, you know, indefinite are also known as countable quantifiers, and quantitative determiners are actually known as uncountable. That means they are used before uncountable nouns. Much, little, a little, the little, some, any, enough. So you can see that some and any are used as indefinite numeral as well as they are used as quantitative determiners. That means they are quantifiers also. So first we will discuss the uses of indefinite and quantitative determiners simultaneously, and then we will switch to distributive numeral determiners. A few and few, a little and little. Now see, a few and few are indefinite numeral, a little and little are quantifiers. Their uses are similar, but the only difference is that a few and few are indefinite numeral, that means they are used before countable nouns. A little and little are quantifiers, so they will be used before uncountable nouns. A few and a little, they are both used in a positive way. Few and little describes the quantity in a negative way. Right? Remember, few used for countable, little used for quantity, uncountable, but they are used in the same sense. Like a few represents positivity, similarly a little also represent positive way. Now, few represents negative way and little also represents negative way. But again, the same difference, that few is indefinite numeral, so will be used before countable nouns, whereas little is a quantifier, so will be used before uncountable nouns. Right? Now, a few and a little describes the quantity in a positive way, that means some quantity is there. I have got a few friends, that means there are some friends, maybe the number is less. I have got a little money, that means there is some money. Few people visited him in hospital, that means almost no visitors, that represents negative way. He had little money, almost no money, again negative way. Now few people, countable, little money, uncountable. Similarly, the few and the little. The few is again your indefinite numeral and the little is your quantifier. So the few represents the small number, whatever the number is, but represents the whole. The little represents the whole, whatever the quantity, as the little is a quantifier. Then switch to some and any. Now they are used as both indefinite numeral as well as quantifiers, but their sense is same. If they are, some is used for positive statements, any is used for negative statements. Some and any are used with countable and uncountable nouns. If they are used before countable, they will be indefinite numeral. If they are used before uncountable, they are quantitative determiners. Now their uses. Some is used in positive statements. I had some rice. He has got some books from the library. It is also used in questions when we are sure about the answer. Did he give you some tea? That means we are sure that answer would be yes, positivity, when we are expecting the answer in a positive sense. Then some is also used where question is not a request but a method of making a request. Could I have some books, please? So, then any. And any is used in negative statements. Have you got any tea? That means the expected answer would be negative. That is no. He didn't give me any tea. I don't think we have got any coffee left. So, they are such examples. Now, some in positive statements, then questions, then any in negative statements, and then in interrogative statements. The basic thing for some and any is that some is used for positive sense and any is used for negative sense. If they are used in interrogative, that means if some is there, expected answer is yes. If any is used in interrogative, the expected answer is no. Some valuable, she has some valuable books. Books are countable. Here it is working as indefinite numeral. Philip wants some help. Can we count help? No. Here some has been used as quantifier. So they are used in the same sense, but it depends on the use whether they are working as indefinite numeral or they are working as quantitative determiners. The basic difference between indefinite and quantitative determiners is this only, that indefinite numeral are used before countable nouns and quantitative determiners are used before uncountable nouns. Then there are some quantifiers which are made from some and any by using thing, body, one, where. Like some plus thing will become something, similarly somebody, someone, somewhere. Similarly any plus thing, anything, anybody, anyone, anywhere. Right? Now again, when the quantifiers are made from some, will be used in positive sense. When the quantifiers are made with any, will be used with negative sense. Compound nouns are used in positive statements. Someone is sleeping in my bed. That means for sure someone is there who is sleeping in my bed. If I am using anything, is there anything to eat? That means I am damn sure there is nothing left to eat. Did you go anywhere last night? Answer expected is no. Same use, some for positive, any for negative. Then many and much. Again, many is your indefinite numeral and much is your quantitative determiners. They are used in same sense, but working depends on the usage, whether they are being used with countable or if they are used with uncountable. Now definitely with uncountable we would be using much and with countables we would be using many. They are used in negative and question forms. How much money have you got? Money cannot be counted, or it can be counted. How many cigarettes have you smoked? Countable. They are also used with to, not so and not as. So this is the use of much and many. Same, much is your quantifier, many is your indefinite numeral, and much will be used with uncountable nouns and many will be used with countable nouns. Obviously with countable indefinite numeral and with uncountable we would be using quantifiers only. So this was the use of much and many. Now enough. Enough is placed before the noun to indicate the quantity required or necessary. That means it is used before the noun to indicate how much quantity. That means enough actually represents plenty of. There is enough bread for lunch. We don't know how many, exact number, we cannot count, but we know, okay, that enough bread is there for lunch. That means it is again a quantifier. It is also used with adjectives and adverbs. We didn't have enough time to visit London Bridge. Is there enough milk for breakfast? That means, again, it can be used as indefinite numeral and can be used as quantifier. If the noun is countable, then enough will be considered as indefinite numeral. If, like milk, time, we cannot count. So it is working as quantitative determiner. But the main job is to represent plenty or sufficient. Then we have several. It is usually used to indicate an imprecise number. That means we are not sure whether, obviously the number is not large, but more than 2. It can be 3, it can be 4, it cannot be 100, it cannot be 50. That means the number is not very large, but it is surely more than 2. There were several deaths during the floods in UP. That means there were deaths. Obviously, there can be 10, there can be 15, but there cannot be 100. Right? So, several is used to indicate the countable noun. That means several is your indefinite numeral. Used before, countable nouns will be working as indefinite numeral. Then all. All is used with uncountable noun. Or if my, your is there, then countable noun in the plural. If this and that, then uncountable noun. If these and those, then countable noun in the plural. That means all is also indefinite numeral as well as quantitative determiner. That means all, if used before uncountable noun, that means quantifier. If used with countable noun in the plural, that means it is an indefinite numeral. All cheese contain protein. All children need affection. All the people in the room were silent. We can count how many people were there. Right? Have you eaten all the bread? Right? That means if used before countable, indefinite numeral. If used before uncountable, then quantifier. Then the last type of numeral determiners, distributives. Now what are distributive determiners? The words refer to a group of people or things, group as a whole or the individual members of the group. They show different ways of looking at the individuals within a group, and they also express how something is distributed, shared or divided. Right? Taken as a whole or taken as individual or taken in series. Now, each, every, either, neither and none. They are distributive numeral adjectives. Each and every. These determiners are used to refer to all members of a group. When? To all members. Each and every refers to all members. But if we talk about members as individuals, we use each. When we make a statement about all of them, then we use every. For example, each and every board member was present in the meeting. That means whole as well as individual. Both have been represented. Today, a laptop and air conditioner can be seen in each house. Individual. Every child taken as a whole. Series. Right? So, this was about each and every. Now, either and neither are concerned with distribution between two things. Either means what? One or the other of two. That means there will be one. If not both of them, then definitely one would be there. That is positive. Neither is negative. Neither means not one or not the other of two things or the people or anything. So either is positive, neither is negative. Which chair do you want? Either chair will do. Right? Then neither chair is any good, they are both too small. Negative. So this was about either and neither. Then none. None represents not one of a group or people or things or not any. That means nothing. None represents nothing. Now, your homework is that you have to revise determiners and its uses thoroughly and do the question given. So, you have to do this question given, that is fill in the blanks with suitable determiners. You will solve this question in your English practice notebook. You may note down the uses of determiners in your practice notebook also, so that whenever you are going to revise again in future, you can get the rules from your practice notebook only. So revise them thoroughly and solve this question in your English practice notebook only.